Aloha and welcome to ILH Boys Water Polo. I'm Sherry Smart, and with me tonight is coach, referee, and All-American Mark Moretzky. How are you tonight?
Doing well, Sherry. Hello.
Coming to you live from the Waterhouse Pool on the campus of Punahou School on this Aloha Friday, October 13th, Friday the 13th, so we expect a raucous crowd. We're just moments away from the first sprint, so let's introduce the teams. Wearing white is the visiting Bulldogs of Les Jardins. Bulldog coaches Chauncey and Braley Hirose-Hulbert lead their team. In the dark caps, the home team Buff and Blue, coming into this matchup with a 9-0 record. Head coach Ken Smith in his 44th season at the helm. And tonight assisting him, Alan Lum, Ikaika Key, and Courtney Miller. Referees for tonight's match, Chloe Barr and Michelle Wong. Here comes the first sprint right now.
I didn't see and the sprint, number, yeah, number 18.
Number 18, sprinting
Ben Crook.
And for Punahou, Jordan Savage.
All right.
Give me some keys to the game for each of these two teams tonight, Mark.
Well, right away, I noticed that Punahou's got a little bit different lineup, which is nice. They're probably going to be able to play some people who haven't had as much time. And so one of the keys that I think is for the players who haven't been in the last couple games in so much to kind of get the rust out.
Yeah, get the juices flowing.
I think they're still going to press. I mean, you can see that right now. They start getting up in the lanes and going to try to counterattack. And really, they've got speed up and down.
Yeah, I think that is one of the keys for Punahou, of course, is to rely on their depth. The Bulldogs of Les Jardins, their bench isn't quite as deep, and they are, you know, they're still a growing program. The twins, the coaches, have really done a really good job with the consistency here in the last couple years, getting these teams, their fundamentals going. And it's still the program in its infancy, and we're really excited that they've maintain a Division I and a Division II team over the last few years. That's really important for the sport here.
Well, and for their program too, right? That's a good sign if they do have the numbers and they're able to at least keep those teams competing.
Yep. So, you know, I don't think they're disappointed in their record. I think that they want to, you know, come out and play. And there's been some good, you know, they've had some really close matches and some good overall play, and they know that this is still a building year for them over at Les Jardins. Punahou, on the other hand, is just loaded, as we know, and you can see with a variety of lineups they're still able to manage. We have our first ejection of the afternoon or the evening here on this Friday.
Yeah, I thought that was a nice call, exclusion. Just center Noah Weldon was just being sunk, and then when the ball came in, the defender is in position having sunk the center.
Goal by number 5, Hayden Comerford for Punahou, one of the seniors on this squad. He shoots that cross cage high, as you can see, and Punahou 1-0 in the first couple minutes of this game.
Looks like they're not having much of a problem moving the ball around, certainly on that power play there.
Was it number 21 for Les Jardins on the ejection? It was a little hard to see the numbers. I think it might have been 21.
I think you're right. I didn't get it. But it looks
good
like
shot block
him.
There, and a decent attempt there by number 18. For Les Jardins, Ben Cook, one of the seniors on their squad.
Yeah, Punahou's doing well. Yeah. Noah Weldon all alone.
Cross pass. Oh, Jason Hiremath with the tricky around the around the head, around the body kind of a shot.
Yeah. A lot of mustard on the hot dog. Didn't get it. Didn't cash it in.
Didn't quite cash it in, but I do like his attitude of, you know, put the ball in the cage or at least attempt at any cost.
Yeah, I thought it got me just given the way his body was. That was the right shot.
Yeah, yeah. We have a kick out here, some on Numba.
Yeah, I didn't see where that came from. Out on the perimeter, maybe a two-handed foul.
Ah.
I was following the cameras here.
So, Laser Dan on the power play, they have, they'll be playing man up for 20 seconds or until the ball's turned over or a goal scored. And in this case, a field block blocks that ball out of bounds. Punahou gets the ball back. It was Hiremath on the ejection. Zach Litsky with the backhand here. And the quick move by the goalkeeper. Get his hands on that.
Yeah, it was good defense there. One thing Les Jardins is able to do, at least for this quarter, is stay with Punahou going up and down. They can do that for a quarter. That'd help.
Yeah, that's always the key to the game for Punahou is to their speed and their depth is really, of course, an asset. And even teams, you know, like Iolani that has comparable speed, they don't quite have the depth. And so it ends up being a factor when you are in your third and fourth quarter. Excellent block there, stopped by that goalkeeper. Matt Easter. With a double, two blocks here.
Good timeout there.
Timeout called, right? Laser Dan's going to talk it over, but really great heads-up play by goalkeeper Matt Easter to get his hands on that really point-blank shot from the 6'7" Noah Weldon.
Yeah, he had a little more time, I think, than he ended up taking. But there, once again, like you said, Easter saves him twice.
So a quick early timeout called by Laser Dan. They're going to chat about it a little bit right here. But we have a 1-0 game with 2:25 to go in the first period. Each team has played man up one time. And they'll chat about it. I think that was a well-timed timeout. Give these guys a little break, have a little chat. You can see the twins, Chauncey and Braley, who of course were players here at Punahou School. And they're looking up at the scoreboard. I'm not sure what she's looking at. Something's happening over there. But
well, the light, even the light on the water changed. They flashed something that had a
maybe
had
it was the
color shift.
Yeah, I'm not sure. But here we are on this lovely Friday evening. It's a little muggy for me. And I heard we were supposed to have some weather.
I had heard thunderstorms, but and maybe somewhere on the island.
Right, I don't want to jinx it, but no. It's certainly not materialized here, which is great for the varsity too. They're having their senior night over there on the deep end. If you can kind of see in the background there, there they are gathering up, taking pictures on the far right of your screen. This is a Division II senior night for Punahou School and the three seniors being honored. And Laser Dan coming out of the timeout with goalkeeper Matt Easter tossing that off to his teammate. Ball goes deep wing. So number 16.
So that, yeah, I was going to say they've been starting out in a press and then kind of dropping into like a little M defense or something.
Right. There's a
not
shot.
Sure, but at least getting up into the gaps there and trying to counter.
Right. So you want to just kind of briefly describe what you mean by an M defense? We call it an M gap.
Yeah, looked like at least that last possession, they just get the defender up there at the point, that X3 defender to come back and prevent a pass to the center, and then you can
gap the
allow the other two defenders to get up in the gap.
And sort of force that outside shot, and the goalkeeper read that all along. Sion Ying here. Laser Dan's on the attack. And
one of those
a little
long
bit of an
Weldon
errant,
arms.
Yeah, I was going to say a little errant pass, but ball goes back to Les Jardins, and I think that's going to be kick out.
Yeah. Yep.
It was up and over. Litsky, Zach Litsky with his whole chest out of the water. I think that's part of it. You get your belly button on the guy's head. I think you're going to take a kick out there. And so Les Jardins passing that ball around. Doesn't look like they've got a lefty over there, so they're going to try to maybe isolate one of the players on the strong side of the pool. And both teams are even here.
The ball's just getting stalled there on the right side.
And a little high cross cage on that one, and now Leisure Dan's in trouble. Punahou on the counterattack. Players open on both sides. Comerford with the ball. He's going to pick that up, take a look, and go to his upper right with a skip this time.
That was nice. And Lejardin actually was, they had the numbers, but two defenders went toward Comerford, and nevertheless, he great shot, like you said. Ball was up high, and then he skipped
to
low.
Skipped that upper corner, and his previous shot was also from at that same angle, but no skip shot on that one. So Comerford 2.
Lejardin 0.
We got 27 seconds. There's about a 5 or 6 seconds discrepancy between the game clock and the shot clock, which now will be erased as Punahou goes on the attack with 16 seconds to go in this period. Liske to Comerford. This is his exact same spot.
Same, yeah.
See if he takes the same before. Shot.
Deja vu.
That's 3 in a
for
row.
Lejardin.
Oh, you're so French.
D'accord.
Are those your two French words? Your two French faces?
That's it.
Oh, mon Dieu.
Bonjour, c'est Marc.
Yeah. Here we go.
Je ne suis pas là.
Well, you are all over that foreign language.
That's about it. Then I.
You run out of things to say. Yeah. Is that it? So, was there any others in between?
Not that I remember. No, I think that's it. 2-0.
3-0.
Excuse me. 3-0. Any others in between? Yeah.
That's right. Any others in between? 3-0. What we're still we need to do is I need to take a minute right now to go run over and ask why we do not have a number 16. Lejardin on the roster, and maybe I'll go run and do that, or should we just call him number 16 for a while? Maybe we'll do that. So we can see Lejardin chatting about it.
Yeah, I think we just go with 16,
we've got a kick out here on Higher Math, and another one over here on number 21, I believe.
Bessinger.
Yeah, for Lejardin, Calum, Bessinger.
So Hirose Hulbert still, she's got a lot of energy in the coaching there.
I know. The enthusiasm and positive attitude is really great. I really like the teaching that these two have done with this Lejardin program. And again, they're really in their infancy as a Varsity 1, Division 1 team. And in order to be able to field an intermediate, a Division 2, and a Division 1 team, I think that's really really a great thing for Oahu Water Polo. And even if it means a few years of growing pains, they're going to build on this. And their record is not an indicator of their growth as a team. So I'm really proud of them for sticking it out.
Yeah, here they come. Lejardin lining up.
And on the Punahou side, we might have a little bit of a different lineup. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, I see Napu Kim's in. And we have the other Weldon. Ben Weldon's is in the game now. And number 7, Skylar Cole, will be sprinting for Punahou. And Ethan Walter, number 2, the dangerous center, or 2-meter player, as we call them.
There he goes.
And also in the lineup for Punahou, Bryce Maitre. And then down at that end right there with the ball. The lighting for me is really tough.
That looks like, I want to say that's still Zach Litsky, huh?
No, it's not. Gunnar Grun, I believe.
Oh, you're right.
Field block there.
And the other Weldon, Ben Weldon in there, lefty.
That's right. Nice. So here we got Lejardin, number 18, Ben Cook, the senior. Seems to be like their point guard there, or their leader. He's always playing up there on the top. looking for somebody to go to. Makes a pass down to the one side. Ball comes back to the top. Punho trying not to foul there because that would lead to a potential shot outside of 5 meters.
Yeah, nice little steal, and once again, Punho on the counterattack.
Skylar Cole out to Napu Kim, Napu to Weldon. Into center, Ethan Walter. That ball gets flicked away by the center defender, Ben Cook.
Yeah, I didn't. Was unable to see on the left side there how the defender got around, but.
Grant Schaefer with the ball for Punho. For Laser Dam, passing it off to number 16.
Oh.
And we've got
ball's down there somewhere. There we go. Nope.
Ball is underwater, and that's actually an infraction, but she's gonna call a jump ball, I think, on that. Yeah.
Seems so like a good decision.
Good decision. Michelle Wong there, former University of Hawaii All-American. And Skylar Cole comes up with that on the tip by Napu Kim. He wins the battle of the
juniors teaming up to
junior.
Take the ball back.
Cross pass, Weldon, the lefty with the ball, goes back to Napu Kim. Punho's doing a good job keeping that ball dry there as they look around. Maitre with the shot, and another nice block from the perimeter. Shot up from the perimeter, blocked by the goalkeeper, Matt Easter. So that means Punho's got a whole new shot clock, and in this case, it's a 35-second shot clock. Some leagues, mostly on the mainland, play with a 30-second shot clock, but we still play with a 35-second shot clock. Ball goes in the center there.
We're on Hawaiian time.
We're on Hawaiian time. Got to give them the extra seconds.
Yeah. Well, when you're down at sea level, I think the air is thicker. Humid night, too.
It's extremely humid right now. I'd much rather be calling this from, floating in an inner tube or something right in there. Oh, I'm surprised that that was a big reach and grab, a little bit of an errant pass.
Yeah, I thought it was the back left hand was just sitting on the shoulder a little bit. It probably didn't affect too much, but enough to give a referee a reason to whistle something.
Yeah, Gunnar Grun with the entry pass that gets stolen away by Matt Easter. Grun, the sophomore for Punho, getting some good minutes here in this game.
So that was good, sort of. At least both decisions seemed
balanced. Yeah. Here comes a shot and a block there by Sion Ying. Oh wait, yeah, that's Sion. All of a sudden, I thought, oh, did they switch goalies? But
no,
not yet.
The glare on. Off the water, actually, when you.
You can tell on the screen that looks a little glary.
Yeah.
And there's
a nice
tight
defensive move.
Yeah,
again.
Defensive current.
Napu Kim.
The tight defense, and up in the lanes by Punho is pretty brutal. Another point blank stop by Easter. He is earning his capped colors tonight, his stripes.
Got another block for his basket.
No kidding. Though, it takes a lot of courage to get up like that right when the ball, those are powerful shots. Most people shy away from a ball flying at their face.
Yeah, no, he did a good job.
Two hands up on that, didn't shy away. Number two, Nalu Blair with the ball right here. Wondering if he's gonna look for looking for an entry pass, but trying to thread the needle there. It's a little tricky to go up and over the defense and land that ball perfectly in front of his teammate, and
especially from that angle with defenders coming from both directions, and just too much, I think.
Yeah, I think so too. Number seven, Skylar Cole's going to pass that around into Mike Tree, and we're going to have an ejection here. Exclusion on number two, I believe, Nalu Blair.
Ethan Walter there earning the exclusion.
Yeah. Yeah, Ethan is pretty deadly there at center for Punahou. He's got really great positioning and works real hard to get, you know, get centered, get set up nicely. Mike Tree with the winding up on that.
Yeah.
With the little helicopter fakes, ball goes just wide.
Be a little higher.
Yeah, he's got that really long release point. His shots selection is usually pretty good. Oh, we're getting a little help here from Coach as she walks by the table here and try to identify our number 16. So Laser Dan passing that ball around.
Again, the press really making it difficult for them to move the ball around the perimeter, really move the ball at all and get it go to tap. Almost perfect pass, but I think it's going to be good enough.
Get a cross pass there.
There we go.
Napa Kim taking it on his own.
With Skylar Cole on the weak side.
Yeah, Skylar's like, I swam all the way down here. Come on.
Yeah.
Where's my cross pass? No, that was a nice shot by Napa Kim. He knew his teammate was there if he needed him.
You know, and I think I said classmates. Skylar's a senior this year, right? Napa's a junior.
That's right. Skylar Cole's one of the speedsters on this team. He's on a record-breaking relay team, I believe, or at least championship-level relay team in the 4x100 freestyle, so he's quick. And we've identified our number 16 for Laser Dan. It's Joe Lyons, the senior.
Joe. Well, the long arms and just good repositioning saved Cole on that play. I mean, he was beat and then swam there, pushed the ball, got a steal, and turned it into a goal.
Lefty Elijah Muzzy with the goal there, and a real hard counterattack again, and he snuck that in on the bottom left, or bottom right, actually, I guess, bottom left of the goalkeeper.
Yep.
Muzzy, one of the senior, he's only a junior on this team, too, so.
They've been around for a while, these guys.
I know, I feel like he's, but good for him, getting that nice counterattack goal. Ben Cook with the ball for Laser Dan. He's trying to go into center to number two, Nalu Blair. Nalu's trying to get that off to his, there's a nice quick idea. Good idea there.
We're staying in the press pretty well, but somehow on that play, again, the center was just out of the frame, but on that play, Ben Weldon was suddenly underwater and the ball entered.
Yeah, so there's Ben Weldon, another lefty. So there's two lefties in the pool for Punahou right now. Walter with the grab and turn.
Using that hook again, the meat hook. Maybe
that's
what it is.
Yeah, he used the meat hook with his right, and he used the meat hook with his left to grab the defender. I mean, you can see maybe perhaps on the replay, his left arm was wrapped around underneath the guy's armpit and over his shoulder, but that's what gave him the leverage to make that turn move.
At least on the far side there, where the referee couldn't really see it.
Yeah,
nice little move.
All right. At the end of the first half of play, Punahou 5, Lejardin 0.
Zero, yeah.
So these two teams will switch ends, and they'll have a moment to chat about it. Maybe look at a new lineup for the start of the second half. And maybe a goalie change, not sure about that yet. We'll see what happens for Punahou. Laser Dan likely will stick with their same starting group. They'll get a few minutes to take a break and see what happens after that. So we are in the start of the third round. The way the ILH Varsity Division I season goes is each team plays each other three times in the regular season, and we are at the kind of smack dab in the middle of the third round. And when that's over, we go to a championship tournament.
Tournament time, yeah.
And the dates of the tournament, November 1st and November 3rd, here at Punahou School.
Four teams will make
the tournament. And the seating is based on the regular season, so likely Punahou will end up with the number one seed and number two seed. Not sure yet, but likely.
Yeah, I think that'll depend on this third round with Kamehameha and Iolani, I believe, splitting their first two matches. Oh,
that's correct. So yeah. And I believe Kamehameha and Iolani play again on Tuesday night. So the winner of that game is likely to end up with the second seed. However, that doesn't matter that much because the other team will be the third seed and they play each other in the tournament. So it's a 1-4 match semifinal and a 2-3 seed semifinal. So it's likely to be those two teams at 2 and 3, and who's 2 and who's 3 just depends on your cap color. I mean, really doesn't matter that much.
Yeah, maybe a little, depending on what that last game looks like, maybe you come in with a little bit of confidence or momentum, but really you're gonna end up playing the same team.
Right, so the 1-4 semifinal, likely will be,
I believe that's at 5 p.m. On the
5 p.m. is the first semifinal, correct, and that is the 1-4 seed.
Okay.
And that'll probably be Punahou versus Mid-Pacific.
Oh, I was thinking Les Jardins, but
I believe
they are probably the team that's out, right?
Seed,
the fifth
yeah.
team, excuse me.
Likely that, but there's still time, I guess, so we'll see.
No, I believe you're right at this point. Right?
Yeah. With the records the way they are. So four teams will make the tournament, and that comes up on November 1st and November 3rd, and we will be webcasting those live. Look at the nice colors of the sky out there.
Beautiful.
We have anybody tuning in from the mainland? Sorry.
Crayola sunset.
Sorry to tell you. We got this nice evening here on Friday the 13th.
And there we got the close-up. This Punavision all-student-run crew is directed by Jamie Mitri. Hunter Nishikawa is on the replay. And our three camera operators are Diego Ean, Chloe Balisakan, and Paige Dole.
All student-run. Amazing job. They do a fantastic job. And if you're not watching this live, you may be watching it archived, and that's the other way to see ILH Boys Water Polo, either live or on the archive.
On demand.
When your time permits. Looks like we do have a goal change,
demand.
A goalie
Punahou
change.
Water polo.
Demand. I demand it. Noah Peters, the freshman, coming in for the second half here in the goal for Punahou. And the Les Jardins players taking every minute of their break that they can take, which is smart for them to do. It's a tough sport to go back and forth, back and forth. You got to be an excellent swimmer in great shape. These kids are all in really great shape. They do a ton of swimming and a ton of wrestling. A little boxing on the side.
Grappling.
Yeah, maybe some ice hockey with the melted ice. So it's a combo sport. They're very tough athletic players.
And sometimes you take a ball off the noggin when you didn't even expect it. Jordan Savage.
Yeah.
Off the rebound there.
Yeah. So here we go. I'm going to just take a quick double check that we're right on the score here.
Well, and Noah Peters, the sole freshman on the varsity team this year. And it's good he's been able to get some time playing at least a quarter, if not the second half of most games that we've webcast so far. He's an excellent swimmer, and his length really serves him well in the goal here.
I forgot to give Napu credit for the goal, so it's actually Punahou 6, Les Jardins 0. With goals coming from Ethan Walter, 3 from Hayden Comerford, 1 from Napu Kim, and 1 from the junior Elijah Muzzy. Punahou retains possession on that sprint. Jordan Savage with the win of the sprint. We've got another new lineup here. Comerford back in.
Yeah, it looks like maybe the first quarter lineup is back.
Yeah, no, Jason Hiremath on that side. Look at the speed on which he turned that. Just muscled that one through. Both Jason and Ethan Walter have a quickness to them that's really, really hard to defend. And I don't just mean back and forth down the pool quickness. I mean quickness when you're, you know, vertical, ball in hand, the quick moves, very, very difficult to defend.
Yeah, he stepped back quickly there and created some nice distance between himself and the defender. And now out, right, putting pressure on the perimeter.
Yeah.
Back to work.
That's Ben Cook passing it off to Grant Schaefer. Schaefer's going to look for an entry pass here, but that center defender, Titan Mitchell, just gets right around with an easy steal there. Comfort looking for his fourth. Let's see if he goes right side. Oh,
I was going to say, yeah. But just as he was doing in the first quarter, he's starting to lead the counterattack again. This time on the left side of the pool, though, and shooting to the left side of the goal.
That's right. His first goal to the left side. But with a nice, you know, he's got a body length and a half lead on that.
Yeah.
And he took his time to take the right shot. So, you know, and Comerford with his fourth goal on the evening.
Well, with this press, if he can just get up in the lane and get those first couple strokes, you're in good position the rest of the way down the pool.
Yeah, number two, Nalu Blair with the ball, passing it off to his teammate Ben Cook. Ben Cook's going to consider taking a shot there, but neglected to do so. Noah Peters, the freshman, with his first
Comerford
block
again.
of the evening, and his first outlet pass and assist. Caden Comerford, all alone there.
Timeout. So that's the timeout horn.
That is the timeout horn. You think that Coach Ken is going to pull Hayden Comerford after his fifth goal, or you think you leave him in and let him keep powering through the counterattack? What do you think?
Yeah, well, no leads too safe for Coach Smith some days.
Yeah.
They've got some sort of a rotation going, so I'm not sure that we'll see too much substitution. I forget who came in and was mixing through with this group that started this quarter. But it may be those three out there to the right side of the screen standing next to Coach Alan Lum.
I can see
some of the sophomores.
He's the senior, so maybe he stays in for a while. But with five goals on the game and a 9-0 lead, maybe the discussion is try to set something up and run some plays.
Maybe we see
there's
Peyton Ogasuara.
Yeah, Dylan Cole's in.
Dylan Cole, good.
Sophomore.
There we go. We got one of the class of 2020.
Yeah, represent the 2020s.
And brother of 2018, Skylar Cole. So
Hayden
Comerford's still in there. But
let's see if the brothers are playing together.
Yeah, if we've got a brother connection, and I do see Hayden still in there, so.
Well, Hayden's brother used to play here. He's a graduate.
So maybe this is a brothers or those who have had brothers in the program lineup.
Maybe. Well, the two.
Or fathers, because there's Noah Weldon's. But Noah's brother, Ben, is on the team. They played with
Coach Smith.
They were certainly in the last game, I believe, with each other. I don't believe they've been together with each other this game.
Titan Mitchell with that steal there. Well, just picked up the errant pass.
Ward Weldon, of course.
Yep.
Class of 2016 was on the varsity team.
That's right. And he's now playing at MIT. They had a trip to the West Coast, and they're playing really good water polo there for East Coast water polo. Pretty strong. So that's older brother Ward Weldon.
Yeah, this is definitely the brothers' lineup, I think.
I think so, too. There's Noah Weldon trying to use his reach there. Well, it looked like Lazardin recovered the ball, and then they just kind of flicked it away a little bit.
Okay, not everybody has a brother.
No, Litsky's got a sister. She's on our program in the program.
And Higher Math is... Noah Weldon. exploding up from the nether regions where Ogle Pogle the sea monster lives.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure if you could be down there, though, because this is pool water.
Pool water, yeah. You need the sludge.
Ogle Pogle.
For Ogle Pogle.
He used to apparently hold my leg.
That was your nemesis.
You're not playing defense. Ogle Pogle has your legs again. No, Bob, I'm just lazy.
Yeah, just lazy. That's all I can say about it. Oh, gosh. Nalu Blair goes out to his teammate, number 11. He recovers. That's Grant Schaefer, but Pono gets that ball back.
No, that was just right. Good defense, kind of teaming up. Litsky and didn't see who else that was. I think that was Titan Mitchell coming from the backside.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Helping take the ball.
Cross pass to Dylan Cole. Cole to Muzzy. Muzzy goes center and in, and Weldon with a big, heavy shot and another block and stopped there by Matt Easter.
Yeah.
For Leisure Dan.
Maybe Noah, if you're watching this late at night under the covers, right, sneaking in a little YouTube viewing, maybe a big move and step forward.
Ah.
But
Coach Bretzi's giving you some tips.
Yeah, teaching the centers. But, boy, that was a... He's got great position.
Yeah.
Really makes it with those long arms easy for people to pass to him.
Yeah, Nalu Blair, the shot clock's about to run out, and Desjardins does get that shot off a little bit high. Coach Ken Smith called a 20-second timeout, which is probably just a substitution timeout here.
See, that's where we make up, actually. We go 35-second shot clocks per possession, but then we only give them 20 seconds rather than the traditional 30 for that transitional timeout. So we get back
a few seconds here.
Right there, but really makes that 35 trade-off a little bit more balanced.
All right, that's kind of sarcasm, right? That's pretty funny.
It might be a little bit. I don't know where we, like,
where
the 20.
Where do we call the 20? Why did they call it a 30, though? Because either a 30-second timeout or 20, one of them really takes a full 20 or 30 seconds. It's really just a substitution timeout.
No, you're right. But the 30 had existed for a while, and
true.
Then for some reason,
the
ILH created, this 20-second timeout. I think the 20 was supposed to really speed things up.
Yeah.
So.
Right. Was it supposed to speed things up?
Oh, well, like I said, maybe
10 seconds.
10 seconds there.
So Puno on the power play on that kick out there, the center defender for.
That power play would just be happening now.
Okay. Here's some cross passing here. Ethan Walter takes a hard shot.
It's a field block. Yeah. Good arms up there, a couple of them.
Yeah, that's pretty good discipline there by Leisure Dan, getting those hands up on those. Napu Kim with the lob and the little help from Skylar Cole.
Tapping it in with those.
The ball has to completely cross the plane of the goal to count as a goal. So Napu Kim gets the assist, actually, and Skylar Cole gets the goal.
Cole
and a goal.
With the goal.
Cole with the goal.
So we traded Coles, right? So Skylar's back in and Dylan went out.
All right, Cole trade. Okay,
Cole
good.
Trade, didn't? Yeah.
Ethan Walter's still in. We have an ejection on him, though. He'll sit out for 20 seconds. And the Leisurden errant pass there throws that away. Although Ethan Walter, the ejected player, still has to leave the field of play, go into the penalty box before he's allowed to come back in. So Pun will be playing a 5-on-6 right now for a few seconds. This is where the 35-second shot clock comes in as an advantage when you're playing a man down. Pretty nice move there.
Yeah, it was good work by Maitre. Bryce.
Yeah, I mean, he's got, that was good body positioning, and he took a full forearm. Yeah, that's tight pressure by Punos.
Yeah, that
proving
was
to be difficult.
Kim up in the lanes just taking that outlet pass.
Number 8, Bryce Maitre's going to slow down the offense a little bit. Passing that off to Napu Kim. Defending him, number 13 for Desjardins, Scott Parrish. Number 11 for Desjardins on the foul. I'm looking to see if sometime soon they might start sending players off to play some offense. That's it. From here, that's a nice corner. Muzzy not ever afraid to shoot. That lefty, he'll shoot from anywhere at any time. That one was blocked out of bounds by the goalkeeper, so Punahou will get a whole new shot clock and a corner throw.
Out there, there we are.
Mike Tree with the ball goes into center and tip that ball out to Muzzy. We'll see what we got. Some offensive action there, cross, you know, isolating cross cage there.
And we end up with the lefty down
lefty
in the corner
on the wrong
there.
Side of the pool. Yeah, that's like one of my pet peeves.
Yeah.
Actually, really, I think it's such a waste to put your, even if it was a drawn up play, he's going to drive across the cage. You just wasted your lefty on the good side of the pool.
Yeah. If we're counterattacking, maybe head to that post so you can work your way back across. But really, don't want to use your sole lefty down there in one position.
Yeah, Ben Cook with a pass. He's going to go to his teammate.
Although I will say for a split second, I thought they had a nice little diagonal pass to Ben Weld, and he could have tipped it in with his left hand, but that really wouldn't have been your, you know, your highest percentage attack.
Nope. So at the end of three, we have a 10-0 game here.
Yeah, I was gonna say we can look out at the scoreboard, but I think we're in the double figures.
Oh, I'm sorry, 11. I think it's 11 now. 11 and again, now. We can't see the scoreboard from where we're sitting, but my records show 11 points. But we'll go take a look right now and see what you see on our sky high scoreboard here.
Venture out onto the pool deck here. Yeah, 11-0, with about a minute and 25 seconds left in this break.
And then we'll start our fourth quarter. Lejardin probably going with the same lineup, generally speaking. Punahou doing their platoon change. And these, Coach Ken Smith and Allen and Ikaika, have some games or strategy that they played during practice to figure out what the lineups are going to be. And it looks like we have Jordan Savage coming back in.
Here we got Ogasuwara. Of course, we're looking at the Lejardin team, but Sherry and I are looking over at the Punahou kids in the pool. We've got an unidentified swimmer, number 21. We'll have to see
if he comes a little closer, I can see who that is, but right now I don't know. So we got
the Rosie Hulbert twins can't figure it out either. Who is 21?
I'm not sure if they're even caring.
Scratching foreheads. We've got confusion reigning supreme over there. That's the Coltrane, isn't it?
What?
Yeah, do we have a new goalie here?
I believe Owen Pyle's in for Lejardin now. Goalkeeper Owen Pyle, Jr.
Matt Easter rises out of the pool to the bench.
Takes a little break. He had a really great game so far. Really saved a lot of goals there.
Well,
point
actually,
blank.
No.
Do you think that's
him? Easter is back in.
Okay,
yeah,
that's Easter. I'm sorry.
Sorry, I thought he has risen again.
I thought that was, okay. What? Wait, really? His name really? Is Easter.
Well, I know. It's just Thanksgiving coming up.
Matt Easter,
no, Halloween.
We
sorry.
Appreciate your play, Matt Easter. We are not teasing you. You are playing fantastic water polo.
Oh, he had some of the blocks that kept him in the first quarter there.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can remember back to three quarters ago now as we start the fourth.
Dylan Cole, number three for Punahou, is going to kind of walk the ball around, look to see who he should go to. He's going to Jordan Savage. Savage goes in to Weldon. That's Noah with a big step-out move. Blocked by Easter right at his belly.
Yeah, sort of the four square feet you didn't want to aim at. The Easter body rising out of the water. And that one was not... That was no pun intended there.
Right.
It was egg beatering up. How's that?
You can speak without the puns intended.
Full of them. Full of it or full of them?
There's some movement here. There was a nice ball goes into center there. Number four, Noah Gobert for Lejardin. I think Coach Braley Hirose Holbert's looking to get something. some sort of help maybe from the referees, but I'm not sure if there's anything they can give her right now. Somebody's open cross cage. Peyton Ogasawara will have the ball here. He's going to kind of attack in. Sent that ball in to crowded space there. We do have a laser down on the counterattack. That's number 16, Joe Lyons, with the
And Peters. Great initial block, and just turning it, you know, unfortunate, right? Tips the ball, the rebound in there.
Yeah, I credit it. Yes, that was a great shot by Ben Cook. Good job by Ben Cook, or being heads up play off.
18.
Yeah, that's 18. 16. I thought, actually, for a second, I thought it was number 16, Joe Lyons, but it's number 18, Ben Cook.
And 16, Noah Weldon throws the ball back and heads once again to his center position. Well, they've definitely been effective feeding him. And
there's a kick out there. Do you see that 16?
Have been Lyons, but meanwhile,
Muzzy.
You can see Muzzy.
Elijah with his second goal of the day. He's on the three post there with the left hand. Make a clean pass to him on that one. That's going to be an easy goal.
So Lejardin will send in the replacements, the troops, new substitutes.
Yeah, number three, Luke Ferreau for Lejardin. He'll stay in, but the rest of them platooning out. We've got number 21, Kalen Bessinger coming in. Number 25, Evan Kays. He's got the ball there at the middle of the pool. Passes that back to his teammate, Nalu Blair. Nalu tries to take the reverse spin, goes back the other way. Angus Tanner, number 17, seeing some playing time there for Lejardin.
Still getting that pressure, if the ball goes in, you got a center defender playing behind.
That's a beautiful, actually great move and great stop. Both sides of the ball there.
Yeah, we've got Dylan Cole.
Dylan
Class of 2020.
Cole. 2020 represent.
So continuing the Cole tradition of leading that counterattack.
Yeah, I'd love to see that replay down here on this on that last attempt by Lejardin from center, and this
the
really
step
nice
out there.
Yeah,
huh?
The step out move was good and really quick. And Noah Peters just got a hold of that. I think both sides of that were really great water polo skills by both teams. Kalen Bessinger down to his teammate number 13, Scott Parrish. He gets fouled. Scott's the lefty there. First time we're seeing the lefty in for Lejardin in a while. 25, Evan Kays. Looking for an outlet pass. Should go right back into center there. He's set up.
Yeah, it's hard to see, but this press needs, I would say, to be complemented by Savage coming around and fronting so those balls don't
come in. Right here, number 25 should take this shot. And Noah Peters with the point-blank stop again. Peters, the sole freshman on this team for Punahou. Yeah, he's got an illustrious career ahead of him. Oh, I see what's happened. That is Sion Ying playing in the field for Punahou. That's number 21. He was taking a few laps, and we're like, what is happening? Now we know.
I see, says the blind man.
There's
Muzzy.
Muzzy getting crunched there, but.
Got his shot off, just wasn't on frame, deflected out. Lejardin bringing
Nalu
the ball
Blair
up.
Bringing the ball up.
Gunner Gruen making a steal and now receiving the outlet pass.
Yeah, Gruen's gonna come and attack. He's also representing 2020. Takes a shot, bottom left. That's his signature shot, skip shot there, or skimmer. I call those a skimmer.
skimming right under the surface. Skimming along the surface.
Yeah, like skipping a stone just about.
We've
got some substitutions coming in from both sides.
Both sides, huh?
And we do have the backup goalie in, Owen Plow, for Lejardin at this point. Nalu Blair bringing the ball up.
Still pressure.
Goes into Faroe, and there's turn and shot by number four, Noah Gobert, for Lejardin. Goes a little high, but he comes on back on defense.
You know, I'd have to guess maybe the idea is to let Jordan play a little defense behind and try to, try to survive and do something when the ball comes in, because that's been what's happened the last
right,
few possessions,
crashing,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no one crashing, not a lot of worry about it. Yeah. So let's not fault Savage for a poor decision. I'd be betting he's following directions.
Sion
involved in deflecting a ball around the goal.
Yeah, he that's his spot, right? Right in front of the goal. He's the goalkeeper normally. He gets to play a few minutes in the field. And he took a shot. Ball goes off the goalkeeper's hand, so Puno retains possession with the corner throw. Pass a little close to the body there.
Sion now thinking he can play center, dish it out. I'm the postman now. Let me sit at the two post. And
Gretch,
I want that ball. Every goalie thinks that. See, there we go.
Yes.
Every goalie thinks he's a field player.
Well, he just proved that he can do it with the assist.
See, this is the logic that leads to goalies thinking that they're field players. One success. One moment of success does not yet equal a pattern. Sion staying the goal.
he's having fun out there right now.
One of
our seniors, and because he is sharing time in the goal with the future Noah Peters, he's decided, why not? Coach Ken Smith said, hey, give him a few minutes in the field.
Well, and the goalies always like to be down there where they can use their legs. So, Sion, we're just ribbing you.
Yeah, it's fun to score, isn't it?
Don't even remember.
You don't know what it's like. That's a good move
it's been
there.
Too long.
That Gunnar Grun on that grab and go. He had a little claw
the meat hook
on
too,
that.
Huh?
Yep.
Yeah.
Outlet pass from Owen Pyle. Bringing the ball up for Lejardin. Faroe with the ball here. He's going to try to attack. Just mishandled slightly.
And Ying making the steal, darting out with those goalkeeper legs.
Yeah, and then cruising up. Not quite used to the back and forth. Grun with the ball on the perimeter. He's going to look to go inside to his teammate. Ball goes in. I believe that's the left. Ooh. Wow. That was a great little attempt there. Ball goes off the inside corner, or kind of the, inside corner of the goal, and pops right back out.
I have to admit I was looking away, distracted by
Noah Gobert,
21st century technology.
With the shot at the buzzer.
I think there was a little bit of a field tip there that deflected that goal into the post. And fini.
I think we have a 15-2 game.
Two? Was it two?
Oh, one.
I missed the.
Sorry,
I think it was
it's
one.
Only one.
Yeah.
Again, we're not. I'm keeping track here, but it was a little hard to figure out since we can't see the scoreboard. But at the end of four,
our statistician is out tonight.
Yeah, Punahou wins that game, and we'll play again on. Let's see, it's Punahou plays again coming up, away game.
Away game at home against,
away game
sorry.
Against Kamehameha. Up at Kamehameha on the 18th.
Yep, and then returning home for an away game against Mid-Pacific.
Yeah, do you want to explain what you mean by that?
Well, Mid-Pacific plays all of their home games away. They've got a pool on campus, but not really suitable for official play. So their game here, they will be the home team despite playing at Punahou's pool.
Right. So Pono playing up at Kamehameha this week on the 18th, or next week on the 18th, and Laser Dan playing against Midpack at Iolani also on the 18th.
And they're in the same boat. I don't know. I'm really mixing my metaphors now. But they'd also, I mean, we talk about programs surviving despite a lot of challenges, a lot of adversity. But they're also practicing in a pool that's not really good for hosting
for
official games for
correct.
Competition. So they travel over the hill. They got that beautiful ride every time
they
come over the hill to play a home game at an away pool.
That's it. So that'll be the end of the third round for each of those two teams this week on the 18th. Punahou plays one more time against Mid-Pacific on the 24th before the tournament, which begins again. We'll repeat that information in case you'd like to watch live on November 1st, 5 p.m.
5 p.m. for the first game.
And 6:15 for the second game.
Which should be the 2-3... Barn burner.
That's right. That's a big one.
I shouldn't even use that right now. Though.
Oh, yeah.
Thinking about California.
Yeah, we'll
all
send
right.
our hearts.
It'll be a tight match. But
tight match.
Yeah.
And good. Then on the 3rd, November 3rd, the finals right
the finals.
Here. Third place game at 5 p.m. and championship game at 6:15. We'll see you then.
I'll see you.
I think
we'll
I
be
will.
Here.
Good to see you. And
have a good weekend, everybody. PSATs tomorrow. If you're a sophomore watching,
go to bed.
You got to be here by 7:30.
Bring
two
reminding.
Number two pencils.
That's
bring your
right.
calculator
and an ID.
And an ID, a Punahou ID, is what I understand.
I they guess all so. And leave your cell phones in the car.
Leave your cell phones in the car and your smartwatches.
Ah, see,
as
those
well.
Are problems that we did not have.
No. I did not have that.
I didn't either. So we will see you again soon. Thank you for everything this evening. And
thanks to this Punavision All-Student Crew. Good night.
Awesome job. Good night.
Night.